हमेशा खुश रहिए। आई एम डॉक्टर अंचित फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी। वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग आवर सीरीज ऑन सॉफ्ट टिश्यू इंजरीज एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू पिक टुडे विल बी सॉफ्ट टिश्यू इंजरीज ऑफ हिप एंड पेल्विस एंड द सब टॉपिक विल बी आई टी बैंड सिंड्रोम। सो लेट्स बिगिन। वॉट इज आई टी बैंड सिंड्रोम? आई टी बैंड सिंड्रोम इज अ ओवर यूज इंजरी ऑफ द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू ऑन द लेटरल साइड ऑफ द थाई। So IT band, also called iliotibial band, is a band of connective tissue that runs from the iliac crest and ends up at the tibia. That is why it's known as iliotibial band. This is a major stabilizer of the hip and knee. The function of the IT band is to stabilize the knee. It helps in both flexion and extension of the knee, and as well as it is a hip abductor also. Since there is no muscle present on the lateral side of the leg, this is the connective tissue which is responsible for the hip abduction. So this is a thick structure which runs from the iliac crest, passes the hip joint, passes the knee joint, and gets inserted into the tibia. So it crosses two joints. So the longer the connective tissue, the more it is prone to some kind of an injury. So why does IT band syndrome happens, and what is IT band syndrome? So as I've mentioned that it is a overuse injury. So what happens is near to its insertion, after it crosses the femoral condyle, lateral condyle, there is a constant rubbing which happens because of constant flexion and extension. So it is mostly present in athletes who involve constant flexion and extension of the knee, mainly in long runners or in cyclists. So these are the both activities which involves a lot of flexion and extension of the knee. So since it is a major stabilizer, it is responsible for flexion as well as extension. So during flexion and extension, in a normal phenomena, the IT band just passes over the femur, and there is a bursa which is present there, which helps in lubricating it and sliding it over. Sometimes the bursa gets inflamed and it makes the IT band rub over the lateral condyle of the leg. So whenever rubbing happens, the IT band gets irritated and gets inflamed, and that condition is known as IT band syndrome. So now we have to understand, why does it happen? Why does the inflammation or the irritation happens, and in what kind of a people, what is the actual cause of it happening? So basically it is majorly present in a people who are athletes. It happens in people who do not warm up properly, that is the form is not correct. In case they have warmed up also, the form is not correct, that is the kind of technique they use is not good. So basically cyclists, runners, and heavy weight lifters who do squatting with weight. So they do not have a good form, they do not warm up properly. Like in case of runners, many a times what happens is when they run on a track, so there is banking of the road, that is the track is also like elevated from one side and decreased from one side to allow water to seep through on the land. So if they keep on running the same way, what happens is right leg is always shorter than the left leg. So left limb length discrepancy occurs. Because of that, the right IT band and the left IT band, when right leg's IT band and the left leg's IT band, the length is deferred over the period, long period of time, because of which shortening of one leg and lengthening of one leg. So since the right leg is always on the upper side, the left IT band gets stretched, and because of the stretching, it loses its elasticity, and as opposed to the right leg. So when the muscle imbalance occurs, so it is a major cause of IT band syndrome. When there is a muscle imbalance occurring, and when there is a pelvic tilt, improper postures, in case of people who wear shoes having different soles, sometimes the sole wear off, sometimes the quality of the shoe is not good, so one leg is lengthier than the other leg, again the same scenario as well as running. So there is a limb length discrepancy which gives rise to the muscle imbalance. Muscle imbalance creates a lot of muscle imbalance in the pelvis. The pelvic tilts, one side muscle lengthens, other side muscle shortens. That causes the connective tissue to rub against the epicondyle, which results in inflammation. So this is how it happens. Now what will the patient present with? What will be the clinical symptoms? The patient will present up with a pain in the lateral side of the knee that will just be above the knee joint, just below the femoral condyle and just above the tibial condyle. So just above the joint line on the lateral side, the pain will be present, and the pain will be maximum during the heel strike phase of the cycle. So whenever a patient initiates a step on the heel strike, the pain will be felt there. While cycling also, when the it's a full extension and just before flexion, the patient will experience pain. Sometimes along with tenderness, swelling can be seen in the joint when it has been chronic, when the inflammation occurs. Sometimes due to many times inflammation, there can be a scarring of the IT band which can be seen, which can be palpated through the fingers, and sometimes the pain might run through above on the IT band. So because of that pain, hip adductors become, abductors become weak, so gait is also impacted, muscle strength is also impacted, and pelvic tilt can pelvic tilt is also not natural, it is not neutral, so the pelvic tilts to the opposite side. So now these are the clinical symptoms that patient will present. Now coming on to the treatment, what will the treatment be like? Medical treatment will overcome the pain, the doctor will advise painkillers, NSAIDs, corticosteroid injections. Coming on to the therapeutic treatment, first of all, we have to figure out the reason of the syndrome, what is causing. So we have to first assess. Before that, coming on to the special examination, how will we different examine that it is IT band syndrome or not? So there is a basic test. The patient will be asked to squat to about 60 to 70 degrees with his hands on top of shoulders of the therapist, so that he doesn't fall. While he's squatting down, the therapist will palpate the lateral side of the knees and will check for any crepitus or any popping sound, and simultaneously will put pressure on the lateral epicondyle. If there is a pain there or if there is a crepitus present, that means it's IT band syndrome. Also, the patient will ask, the patient will be asked to abduct the leg, so and compare both the legs. So usually the affected leg, the degree of motion is decreased as compared to the unaffected leg. Tenderness is present on the affected leg or on the lateral epicondyle. So this is the examination to see the patient to confirm that it is IT band syndrome or not. Coming on to the rehab of the IT band syndrome, first we have to figure out the treatment, the cause of the IT band syndrome. So we make the patient, we check the limb length, we ask about his activities, if he is running on a hillside, if he is running on a banking road, if he is using improper footwear for a longer time, if there is a pelvic tilt, we check for the posture, we check for the pelvis. So once the problem has been figured out, IT band has to be stretched. So the basic funda is to stretch the IT band. The stretching of the IT band can be self also, can be with the help of therapist also, that is passive stretching or dynamic stretching. For dynamic stretching, what the patient has to do is, while standing, he just has to cross the legs and bend towards one side, which will put pressure on IT band. I cannot just perform here, so if my e-notes will have a guideline of stretching. So stretching is very important. So stretching of IT band, simultaneously all the structures around it gets affected. So we have to stretch the glutes also, we have to stretch the hams also, we have to stretch the quads also. So basically stretching of all the pelvic muscles, stretching of all the hip muscles, and then strengthening of all the hip muscles. So this is the rehab of IT band syndrome. We have to strengthen it, especially the abductors, adductors of the other leg, abductors of other leg, adductors of this leg, hip flexors, extensors, and the major treatment is to find out what is causing it and to eradicate that cause. So this was about IT band syndrome. I hope the things are clear. In case of any issue, you can just text me, put a comment below my video. Thank you so much. This video was brought to you by Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Digital Version 2.0. Thank you. Have a good day.